Hey everyone, one of the coaches of Unger Academy here, and today we're going to be talking about another widely used indicator in trading, the Donchian Channel. I'd like to talk about this indicator because in our previous videos we spoke about other indicators which are also built on price channels, namely the Bollinger Bands and the Keltner Channel. If you haven't seen these videos, I recommend you watch them because they are really very useful. But before we start, please remember to subscribe to our channel and click on the notification bell and leave us a like. They're small gestures, but they really matter a lot to us, so thank you very much.
Hi, we are the Unger Academy, and we teach traders how to make money in the markets. Our founder, Andrea Unger, had been struggling with trading for years until he developed his automated trading method, which he used to become the only four-time world trading champion. Subscribe to our channel for free tips and tricks.
Now, the Donchian channel, also known as the price channel, consists of two bands, as we've just seen on the charts, an upper band and a lower band. These bands are calculated using a simple function that identifies the highest high of the last X periods and the lowest low of the last X periods. Then there is also a version that includes a mid-range line, which is nothing more than the average of the upper and lower channels. Plotting these variables, we'll now leave out the mid-range line, we get the lower band and the upper band of the channel. And this price channel will update when the price reaches a new high or a new low in the last X bars, where X is a number we set as an input. Obviously, we can optimize the number of periods to see which one produces the best results. Here we see some examples of how the Donchian channel is calculated. We've set 20 periods, and since we're using hourly bars, the bands of the channel identify the highest high of the last 20 hours and the lowest low of the last 20 hours. Whenever there is a new high, the upper band will update, just as when there is a new low, the lower band will update. Now, this is what happened in these cases, where you can see that the price has risen enough to break through these levels, and as a result, on the next bar, the price of the channel, in this case the upper channel, is then updated. This indicator can be used in various ways, and both in trend following and in reversal strategies. This means that we can use it when we want to trade in favor of the trend, thus buying when prices break through the upper channel and selling when they break through the lower channel, or against the trend, thus buying on the lower channel and selling on the upper channel. The classic theory suggests to use this channel in a purely trend following strategy, so we'll focus on this type of trigger in the rest of this video. As always, MultiCharts and Power Language, programming language created specifically for trading, come to our aid and make our lives much easier. Here we see a simple strategy with very few conditions that will serve our purposes. We've set as input the periods that we're going to use to calculate the indicator. Then two variables, the upper channel and the lower channel, that identify the two bands of the channel, the upper and the lower. These bands are calculated very simply. We see it here in rows 5 and 6 through the highest FC function, where FC stands for fast calculation, which is a speeding up of the highest function, and the lowest FC function. And these functions identify the highest high of the last X bars and the lowest low of the last X bars. I've also included two conditions for skipping the first bar of each session because, well, as some of you may know, there may be pitfalls when we open positions during the first bar of each session. Further down, we'll then have the entry conditions of the strategy. And we see that we'll buy with stop orders on the upper channel and sell with stop orders on the lower channel. Using this simple strategy on a very large portfolio and using a 60-minute time frame, so using hourly bars again, from the 1st of January 2008 until the 28th of December 2021, we see that we can already get some good results. So let me show them to you now. The equity line grows fairly steadily, apart from the last 3 years, where we've seen a general deterioration in performance, but nothing too dramatic, to be honest. We've currently set 20 periods as the default value, but perhaps optimizing this parameter too would allow us to get an improvement. In any case, the results are certainly satisfactory. We see that all the markets are profitable except one, and we're happy with that. I mean, gold, as we can see above, soybeans, heating oil, and RBOB gasoline stand out among the rest. Coffee, which is another trend-following commodity, is also doing very well. Of course, at this point, the overall average trade would still not be sufficient to safely activate the strategy on all of these markets. But this strategy can certainly represent a good starting point to work on some commodities. Moving on to the optimization of the periods used to calculate the Donchian channel, let's evaluate the stability of the parameters that we've set. As an initial parameter, we'll use 10 periods, and as a final parameter, 200 periods in steps of 10 periods. We can see that all values from 10 up to 100 are profitable. We can see that the very first values are the one that produce the best results in terms of net profit, because obviously the frequency of trading will be higher. Let's take 20 as a good starting point, but don't forget to look around for other combinations that can give good results, perhaps even with a reversal approach. At this point, we can close by saying that the Donchian channel is certainly a very useful tool that can be suitable for trend following markets, but that may also be useful in reversal strategies. This is proven by negative results we see in the lower part of the optimization report. Moreover, this price channel could also be used as a trailing stop to close our positions. So this is certainly a versatile indicator, although it may need some, you know, further tweaking to be used for live trading. Thanks so much for having been with me so far, and I really hope that this video has helped you. Remember, if you haven't already done so, please go and leave us a like. And as always, we invite you to subscribe to our channel and click on the notification bell to stay updated on the release of all our new videos. In addition, in the description of this video, we're going to leave you a link to a webinar by the four-time world trading champion Andrea Unger, who will explain step-by-step how you can become successful with trading systems. Thanks again, and we'll see you soon. Bye-bye.